costume artist. Today I'm going to be doing a whispered comic book haul with some finger tracing on the covers as requested by the obsessed gardener. I also want to do a shout out to Matilda Gothica's channel. She shouted me out this past week. She does haul videos and she draws some of her own art and stuff. So check her out. I'll leave a link below for her. First off, we have the Michael Turner Legacy Tribute. He passed away 10 years ago, so this is a tribute book to him and the work he's done. And it just features a lot of artwork and a bunch of different stories about people who knew him. When he first passed away, I used to have the tribute book that was done then, but sadly, it was one of the things that was stolen from me. So, if you guys are interested in a detailed reading of all these stories here, let me know and I'll do a video on that. But if you loved his work, I do recommend, you know, it's just good to have a nice little tribute book to him, you know. I was fortunate enough that I still have the button that came with that old book from when he did pass away originally. So, here it is here. Channels have with like the eating sounds and other things like that, but I might have to start doing that because I want the channel to grow more. And it just doesn't seem like it's growing fast enough right now. But I always try to be upfront my title so you guys aren't really surprised by anything, you know. But I think I do have to do some of those, you know, sound type videos to get other people in, because this is an ASMR channel, but the focal point is comic books. So we have the Red Hood versus Anarchy Wedding Prelude. And I am still behind on all of these, actually, with the exception of the Damien one. some tracing here. Also be doing some live streaming coming up, but it will not be ASMR, it'll just be hanging out with me, and I'm gonna have a Indiegogo for my book coming soon, so keep your eyes peeled for that as well, and I'll have a couple fun things planned for it. We'll have other bonus items you can get besides the comic, so that'll be fun. Next is Batwoman number 16. And this series is actually almost about to wrap. Sure if they're gonna relaunch it or not. I'm gonna trace some of these panels here. Next, we have Man of Steel number 4. Yeah, I'm actually behind on all my books from the previous haul. Anytime I go to a comic convention, it usually happens. Because the weekends are really when I read, so when I do that, my schedule gets thrown out the window. So have you all been enjoying Bendis's run on Superman so far? If you have, let me know below. Like I said, for me, nothing was better than his run on Daredevil. Perfection for me, I loved it. Between him and Alex Maleev's artwork, I like the David Mack stuff too, but you know, his work is known for the Maleev partnership mainly. Next is the Harley Quinn versus Joker wedding prequel, or prelude rather. This Man of Steel number 5. I saw there's some Fabok work in here too, so I wanted to show you both types of the art in here. Turtles Universe number 23. This issue is a Mondo Gecko issue. There's a backup with another artist as well. Says New Justice in the corner. Too, there are some members obviously missing from this group, so I'm assuming there was a shakeup in the No Justice event, but I did not read it, so I don't know. Next is Silencer number 6. Switch artists a couple issues ago on this, but I do enjoy this artist, Victor listen. But I can definitely appreciate the other end of it too, you know. Next is the Terrifics, number 5. doing live streams, guys. Which day and time do you all prefer? I am on Pacific time, I believe. That's one of the drawbacks of whenever you do have 1,000 subscribers, I believe you're actually able to put a notification up on your channel, like a memo that says, hey, this is when our next live stream is going to be. But since I'm not there yet, I can't do that. So I don't know how I'd really publicize other than saying, okay, it's going to be Wednesday at 7, or, you know, whatever. So, but I definitely want to do them, but I want to do it when people are available so they can enjoy, you know. And I mean, I'll stay on for one or two people or whatever even, but, you know, it's better to have one or two than no people at all show up, so. If that makes any sense to you guys. Yeah, I just want to grow more with you all. And I just want this to be, you know, a place where y'all can come and hang out and have it be a place for it that's positive and relaxing to you all. And, you know, I can hear about what you all have done and, you know, vice versa. Because I know not a ton of comments are left. And I know you all have your own thoughts and ideas and, you know, things going on in your life, and I want to hear about that stuff, you know. My career path prior to everything was a minister at one point, a youth minister. So, I mean, I inherently enjoy just hearing people talk and share their stories. And, you know, as I've said before, if you're not a Christian or whatever, that's fine. But I just care about people, you know. That's why I'm making this a relaxing thing for you all as well. To meet the need for, I saw, you know, a spot which, you know, no one was really covering, which was the relaxing side of ASMR for comic books. There's like two or three other people who do it regularly, and it's not often enough, so I stepped in to have a channel where there's regular content. And I do love those other guys, you know. ASMR for Nerds and Chicho are the ones who put out the main devoted comic stuff. So you check them out. Yeah, I've seen other channels do one-offs of it. But I wanted this to be a place where, you know, there's weekly videos and, you know, there's something here for you. And I think we're around video number 150. Five, maybe even now, so I'm churning them out for you guys, you know, to help you sleep or whatever, and everything is in playlists, so you can literally turn on one part and it'll autoplay all the parts after that and just help you sleep, so it's pretty cool. But yeah, I just want to grow this channel, and I want to know more about you all as well. Next, we have New Challengers number 2. number 6. Next is Batman number 49. This is the Urban Legends Old Image reprint. is Captain America 704. Next, I wanted to show you all I got these. And I actually found them at Half Price Books. I paid $15 for each. This is definitely a classic story. A lot of people, well, I would say it's a 50-50 split over people who really enjoyed it and who didn't. Personally, for me, I liked it a lot. And like I said before, this and the Death of Superman, the Return, all that good stuff. I was a little guy. I was around 7 or 8 when all this happened. So to see these big heroes demolished, like, I took it seriously, and I was, you know, thoroughly intrigued and interested in this. So, and I guess they're reprinting these again in smaller ones that will include all the issues, I'm assuming. Even these, they're still missing a few of the issues from the run. This encapsulates the main story, obviously, but there are definitely some glaring missing issues if you look on the back. But if you haven't read them, you don't know what you're missing, type of thing, you know. But yeah, that's a lot of story, you know. So I won't do a full reading of these, but I might do a page turning of one or all three at different times or something. But I know one of the main differences in this, I used to have the trades before, and they did not include the Vengeance of Pain wasn't in there. So I'm glad that's in there, because I actually haven't read this yet. So yeah, there's a couple little variations like that. small, so. But you know how just businesses in general, there's always another opportunity to milk a story, try to cash in on it, so. And I think it's been about 25 years since this happened now, so. On clearance for $2. And this is like Cable's first initial run on the New Mutants, so pretty neat. I like going in half price books because I find a lot of these old vintage out of print trades, you know. I like that they have the original coloring in them. So you really get to experience the story how it was initially prepared, you know. And then it has Cable's first appearance in here, which I read for you all. It's apparently the audio cut out on, but then I got the next Harley trade for $2. About every 2 months, they will go through their shelves and throw stuff on clearance for $2. Because I saw this book at another spot in the store for like $7 or $8. But because they had a copy that had come in 2 months earlier, they just saw it and threw it with the $2 book, so. Original Harley run. I'm not really interested in the current Harley Quinn. I don't know visually like how she's put together in the new book, so. But the original ones interest me. Then this was also $2. I might do part of this and post it on July 4th. I'm not sure yet. But this is like an anthology of Captain America. And it actually includes bonus stuff. This trade has issue number 50 of Captain America, and then the magazine from when he was killed. Initially, I thought it was just this trade, which I used to own, but then I looked, and I saw, and as I was flipping through, I was like, these stories weren't in here, they were in issue 50. And then I looked, and sure enough, sure that this was from Cap 50. Yeah. So it was pretty cool. And then they have the magazine in there too. Talks about the Winter Soldier and all that good stuff. For around $7, and I went in there. I was like, maybe I'll find this because, once again, my Greek friend requested a reading of this on the channel along with Flash. So I was like, well, I'll try my best, and then I found it, so I bought it immediately because, you know, for this to be that low, I couldn't pass it up. But, yeah, this is the Marvel Universe in 1602. This full story, I was aware of it, but I haven't read the full thing, so. and more of them aren't like the covers in it. And that wood carved style, so pretty neat. But I will be doing a reading of this on the channel at the request of my Greek friend. So that's gonna do it for today. And as always, you know, thank you all for coming and watching the video. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you want to see. Let me know about the live streams and all that good stuff. And keep your eyes posted for the Indiegogo stuff coming up. You all have a good day or night. Thanks. Bye.